Jumba Shojo music, it was all and really cool graphics, and it had this whole
It's retro time, ladies.
Hey! Howdy doody! How's it going, my good friend? I'm just gonna get into this game and turn the bloody music down. Welcome to the back office, beneath a steel sky. I'm gonna be playing this and streaming it simultaneously, but it's not really a stream, it's mainly me recording it for YouTube. Now, I haven't figured out how to actually type on the YouTube doohickey whilst I'm in a game because it minimises the window, so I'm a bit stuffed, but I can read your messages. I don't know if you played this before. Text adventure game. A classic. The one thing I do remember from playing this, though, is if I go down to this dude here, he'll quite quickly just shoot me in the face. So how's it going, Andy? How's the old eBay, Amazon wholesaling? Shut tight, a rung. Now you know, might notice my eyes dancing all over the place in this little window thing. I might turn that off actually if it's a bit distracting. And that's because I've got all these bloody monitors all around me. And my game is obviously in this middle section here. Right, so I've got a rung. What can I do with this? Metal bar. Use the metal bar on the door. Christmas? How's it? How are you? What? Andy, how are you, like, worrying about Christmas? I guess you mean Christmas from a business sense rather than from a buying presents for everybody. I hope. Hi Tim, how are you this evening? I'm playing Beneath a Steel Sky, Tim. Do you remember this game? You probably had it on your Spectrum. Right, so the little dude is going to chase me up here, I think, so I've probably got to hide. Yep. Push him off. I kind of remember this game having actual real voices, so I don't know what's going on here. Probably the hooky copy I got, to be fair. Couldn't find my original. Right, he's buggered off. Let's go. So when you say sales have picked up, Andy, is that anything in particular? DVDs, CD-ROM, something like that? No Spectrum here. So Tim, are you really got a C64 right now? You say no money for games, but I think ROMs are pretty easily to download. In fact, I'm going to grab something for you. Okay, this is what you want. Got one of these C64 direct-to-TV joysticks with a billion zillion games on it, and apparently you can reverse engineer it to make it, you know, plug in a keyboard and a hard disk. So that could be an option. Put one of those inside your C64 case instead of all the original junk. Right, use circuit board on robot shell. Oh, it's so annoying it doesn't have the actual voices, because the voice of the robot was awesome. Toys! Andy, I'm going to have to really pay attention to what you're doing, because I know that you sort of keep up with all of the sort of right trends. And if I bought myself a whole pallet load of Beanie Babies, I could probably have a bit of extra, dosh for Christmas instead of spending it on all this junk that surrounds me. Ah, okay. Gotcha. Tim, do you really have that many computers left after you offloaded a bunch of them to me? Oh man, I've not been paying attention to this game. Andy, I don't know how much I need to invest. Are we talking 50 quid here? Maybe 100? I've got three Furbies on the shelf. Can we do anything like with those just to start the ball rolling? Oh, I love this bit. Is that your robot? It's crap, son. Not really. Yeah. Maybe I'll have to start saving up a little bit more. I think maybe at least a grand. A grand would probably be about enough though to get started. You could buy certainly a couple of warehouse pallet of something for a grand. Hello, Mr. Atari staff room. This is Beneath a Steel Sky, and I've suddenly realizing it's a very tricky game to play and talk about because it is a sort of puzzle adventure. I'm just sort of operating on autopilot at the moment because about maybe 15 years ago, 20 years ago, I don't know when this came out, I used to play it quite a lot and got on with it. Now, I kind of recall you want to get in the cupboard, but you get the old guy out of the room. That's about as far as I can remember. I mean, if there's any other game title you can think of, I'm happy to try it. I've got pretty much most PC games here. Andy, I've got plenty of stuff though from the charity shops. I really do. I've got quite a lot of quite good things. Let me show you something here. Now, if we ignore my shelf of DVDs, someone's given me this, which is a whole box of PC games. And I know that PC games generally aren't worth too much. But, they're probably sort of collectible because a lot of them are big box games. Space Quest 3. Now, I never played Space Quest 3. I mean, I occasionally played Leisure Suit Larry and Police Quest, so I kind of think that they might be of the same sort of series. But I've got to admit, never tried it. I guess you'd recommend Space Quest 3, Atari Staff Room. If you are going to recommend it, though, on what platform are you going to recommend it? Come on, get in there, get in there. Oh, bugger. So you can't keep that. I don't know, he's playing to that panel. Let's see if we can get past him. Shh, nah. He's going to follow me in. So when you say scan them all, do you mean literally there's an app you can use to scan the game and it will tell you its value online? Because that would be pretty friggin' awesome. Yep, on the ST. Now, Atari staff room. I've got to say, I'm very excited at the moment because one of my online friends, who I've been lucky enough to meet in person, is selling me for a token amount, I have to admit, an Atari STE, a 1 MB one, which is exactly what I had when I was a youth, and I am absolutely giddy and looking forward to getting that. It's been a long time since I had it on the you know, had an Atari ST, and it's probably the only computer that I ever regret selling. I had it with a monitor. It's the first program I used, learned sort of structured BASIC. I used what was it called? There was a really good BASIC on there by HiSoft. I used STOS. I probably did a little tiny bit of C, never quite into C, but I had the high res monitor and everything, and a bit of Cubase. So I reckon I sort of cut my teeth on that. Because it was next sort of level real computer up from the BBC Micro. And I'm just sort of looking at the moment. Yes, Andy, thanks. Amazon app, yeah, I'm definitely going to try that. Oh, by the way, I got my second Amazon check. Well, hey, I'm rolling in the Amazon monies right now. What I've been looking at on the Atari ST is all these interfaces you can get to try to give you Ethernet and whatnot on them. So I'm just trying. Oh, here, and that's the chap itself. Day of the Tentacle for live stream. Do you know who you are? I don't know. You know, if you're going to enter the chat, sir. I'm just talking on my mobile phone to the chap who is actually selling me the STE, and I don't know if he wants to reveal himself in the chat window. That's up to him. But I won't reveal him. Completely forgot where I was. Oh yeah, so I was looking at the Atari ST and I was sort of trying to think, you can get these Ethernet interfaces and whatnot for it. And by the time you sort of added an Ethernet interface, a VGA, an SD card reader, you know, you've sort of really, it's starting to cost quite a lot of money. So I was sort of considering putting a Raspberry Pi inside the case itself and using the GPIO to emulate a bunch of stuff. So I'd probably get a SD card. I'll probably be able to add Wi-Fi and a few bits and bobs to this, to the ST. And I was also going to take the joystick, the mouse rather, and rip out the innards and put a laser mouse inside with a USB to Atari format adapter within the casing itself. But I don't know, maybe I might just have to leave it vanilla. Yeah, I'm kind of stuffed here, by the way, really getting it's really complicated. I've got two conversations going on here. Right, I'm telling this person to come onto YouTube chat so we can keep it in one place. All right, has anybody actually in the chat played this game to try to remind me how do I get this transporter going? I think you've got to get a sort of cylinder of stuff in it. Okay, Atari asked Star Frame, but you say you've done the RPI in the SD case, but did you just replace all of the innards with the RPI? I guess you just got the Atari ST and just chucked it. I kind of want to do the thing where I keep the hardware original and use the Raspberry Pi as an adapter. I know it's ironic because the adapter's got about 2 billion times the computing power than the actual host machine, but I don't know. I just so regret messing with my original, selling my original Atari, that I really kind of want to keep it virgin. I know that's a surprise for me, the person who does tend to rip out the guts out of everything. Right, let me figure this out. We got to get something in that transporter because he needs to step on that thing and distract that man. Junk, junk, junk. What have I got in my inventory? I've got a metal bar. Right. Nope. Metal bar in the junk. Clearly not going to do anything. Yeah. Come on now, let's concentrate. Now, I think there is, who said this now? Treeguard, 1982. Yeah, this didn't actually come out on the ST, if I recall. There was an Amiga release, but I definitely was in PC territory at this time. I certainly remember at the time there were few games that came out on the Amiga, and only on the Amiga, unfortunately. Oh, there's a lever here. Let's pull that. And one of the most annoying ones which didn't come out on the Atari ST, well, there's two. The first one being Worms. I definitely remember there not being a Worms on the Atari ST. And I definitely remember there not being an XCOM UFO. So those were really probably right down to the sort of end of the platform life. But the Amiga must have just gone on a bit longer. You probably just had a lot more hobbyists using it. Okay, Meth. So, Methanoid's the chap with the Atari ST, and as he's saying here, you can do a pie as a slave to an ST. I'll tell you all about it later, says somebody who sounds like they've actually done it themselves. Good. That's really all I needed to know. Okay, I'm kind of... I don't know, guys. I'm just starting to get really pissed off at this bloody game. Oh, Monkey Island 2. Shit. Let's just go straight for this door, shall we? See what's out there. Oh, I know. Hang on, there's a press. I've got an iron bar. Metal bar in the press. No. How can you say no? Do you remember those text adventure games when you just type in commands that should be totally obvious and it was like, nah. So you can't put the iron bar in the press. Monkey Island 2. Now, I was never a really big fan of the Monkey Island games. I just never tried them. But, now, anybody here, did you ever play Zach... what was his name? Zach McCracken and the Alien something? Someone, come on, finish that sentence. Alien Mind Benders, I want to say. That was great. I really... I definitely played too much of that. And that was probably my first... iron bar and display panel. I'm going to talk to this bloody robot then. Can you start that transporter? How do you expect me to do that? I just... Okay, fuck off then. Right. Alien Mindbenders. Yes. The Hobbit on the ZX Spectrum. I don't know. I wasn't really... I got a ZX Spectrum much later on, you know, when I was probably already in PC territory, way after Atari ST. And the only game I distinctly remember was a game called Mr. Punch. And I don't know if any of you remember Mr. Punch. And that's because it had the crappiest kind of sound effects, you know, synthesized speech. And that's all I remember of the sort of Spectrum. That's all my Spectrum knowledge. The rest of the time is spent on the TRS-80 and BBC-B and Commodore 64. So Zach McCracken was on the Atari ST. ST format. ST format cover disc. Oh my god. I wish I never got rid of my ST magazines. Mr. Punch with a Crunch Back Cane. Right. I'm going to make a note of that. Try Mr. Punch. Punch again. Graphics look a little bit better than the Amiga version. Now here's an interesting fact. Because the Atari ST was like a lowest common denominator system, it was easier to program the games on the Atari ST and then port them to the Amiga because it was more like a straight port. Whereas the Amiga had all the fancy chips, going the other way was too difficult. So I guess a lot of Amiga ports ended up being crap Atari ST ports. Oh, can someone look at a walkthrough? Can't tell us what to do here. I need to get out of here. How do I get that transporter robot going? I'm handicapped here in that I can't switch windows. Hunchback cloak. Kill Thorin with shield. What's that referring to, Meth? Is that your Sinclair game? Oh my gosh, my giddy aunt, as PDFs. What I want is something that always lets me view PDFs properly, like as if real magazines, like a huge ebook. They should do a huge colour ebook that's like a magazine format one. Because I've also want to get hold of all the Judge Dredds. I heard you can get all the sort of Judge Dredd comics in PDF or ebook. I don't know if it's legit or not, but if I had them, I would just love those and just read the grocking hell out of all of that. Oh, okay, whoa, okay, Tree Guard, right. Let's do this, sir. Thank you. I really appreciate the help. Let's go get that junk and then try to steal something out of the locker. That's precisely the yeah, it's not legit but sort of legit, right? I do not remember an Atari ST Dread game at all. Atari Star Room was, I'm guessing it was probably fairly nondescript. I'm not picking it up. I don't even know what it is. That's no use. There's no jug. Yeah, funny. Can you start that transporter? How do you expect me to get that? So Tree guards, we need to know how to actually pick up the scrap metal because the friggin' little robot's not doing it. Unless I threaten to bash him in with the... No, he's just doing an analysis of it. Oh, Tim, that's just so... How much money would I have to give him to have a actual cell or wall art thing or just... something that's just so from 2018? Because when I was young, right, you know that I've got this sort of charity shop dumpster diving background, and you know we were a poor family, as a lot of us were back in the 70s, and you know my mum would get, I don't know where from, probably church fates or something, the various 2000 AD annuals, as well as the I think it was the Eagle, you know, the ones where the sort of Americans are fighting the Japanese and it's going ay, or Vietnamese or Japanese, it was war, I don't know which war it was, I just grew up reading the sort of 2000 AD and the Mekon and all of those guys. It's just phenomenal. So yeah, just to have some physical connection to that would be amazing. Guys, I'm still figuring around this same bloody thing. I'm just going to have to look at a sort of a cheat thing right now. Beneath a steel sky walk through. It says there was a second one here. Do you have the wrench? Oh yeah, I can't open it because Hobbins comes and sort of spanks me. He's sort of getting onto me, so I don't know how to. Maybe if I ask right Joey now, Joey's friggin' useless. If I go to try to yank the lever, he's dissing me. Okay. Oh, are you telling me that stand on the lift? Is it like a time thing? I just got to stand on the lift and just leg it back. Right, let's do this. Right, Tree Guard, I just got your message. I know there's a little bit of lag probably, but let's do this thing. Right, let's go. That's it. So right, I'm going to get into the cup. Look, see, he's after me. He's friggin' after me. Get in there. Come on. Wrench. I'll get the wrench first because it looks more promising than the sandwich. Yes, still got the wrench. Right, let's wrench the hell out of something. Good. So I've got so much stuff going on here in terms of gadgets and crap all around me. I've got to do something this year and actually think about getting rid of it. So, wrench on the transporter. No nuts, this wrench is useless. Okay, wrench on Joey. Joey doesn't want it near his nuts. Wrench on junk. So I don't know. Do I do a competition or do I just do a shout out to some other YouTubers and just say, look, who wants this stuff? Do I try to sell it on eBay and use the proceeds to buy some more tat? All right, Tree Guard, we got to... I think there's more work to be done. We've got the wrench, but I'll go out and distract the guy so I can nick his sandwich. But after that, give us a clue. Squack's Deck Thargo since issue one. What's a Squack's Deck Thargo? A high score. That's a good idea. Yeah, I think, all right, but how about a combination of the both? You know, a high score competition and I'll flog some. I was kind of thinking also it'd be nice to maybe on each episode to have a tombola wheel where we could just have little bits of paper saying, you know, different things, you know, like Sega Saturn, Nintendo, whatever I've got on the shelf, spin it. It's almost too good though, isn't it? Can you imagine winning an Nvidia Shield on a random YouTube lotto? Right, so I've got this wrench. Let's just use it on the lathe. Oh, I think I know what it is. I'm going to put the wrench in the stamping machine because it's a wrench, right? Maybe a chance it's going to spam the shit out of it. So back to Judge Dredd in 2000 AD. Trying to think of episodes or series I like. I quite like the one where he was a sort of went with the. You remember the cowboy judges? There was a sort of cowboy judges that might have been around with riding on dinosaurs, something like that. I do like the fatties, the little wheels. I probably like the Block Wars as one of my favorites. And I really like the fact that when they made the sort of recent film, there was a bit of block war action going on, or at least it showed a single block. But I like that the blocks themselves had war mode. Flesh. Yeah, that's it. Cowboys. Tech City. Matthew sad git. Those comics are for kids. Right, I'm gonna get him back out again and see if I can spanner something. The artwork was so good. People were disappointed by the first movie, the Dread movie, but I thought it was all right. I prefer that to no movie. Don't know how you feel about it. Go west, ask Joey to start the transporter. Okay. We'll have a go. I'm gonna go west west and see if it's if that's where he is needed, if he catches up with me. I wish I played the Atari game now, frankly. PC games are okay. Ah! All right. Let's assume, right, we've played Beneath the Steel Sky and I'll tell you something, guys. I want to show you a game and I kind of want to stop playing Beneath the Steel Sky. So give me a sign that that's okay to do. I've got three screens, so if you see my head looking around, give me a sign if you think I should just continue playing this, or I need to show you what I think is the shittest PC conversion I've ever witnessed. Ever. Ever witnessed. Ever. Ever witnessed. Ever. Ever witnessed. Ever. Ever witnessed. Ever witnessed. Ever. So thumbs up from Tim. Face what? Yeah, I am crap. I am crap at this game, but I really want to show you the next one. All right, thanks for bearing with me. I'm just going to exit this because I thought it was going to be fun to play, but frankly, this is probably the worst streaming game I can imagine. It's just too terrible. Right. These clearly are all games. Oh, yeah, I didn't mean to do what I just did. Yeah, so clearly, you can see a great massive list of games that I own all of them. Come on. Right, it's a really crap interface on that. Right, Captain Blood. Who remembers Captain Blood, right? On the Atari ST or Amiga, right? Because I'm going to leave it on this screen for a minute because, look, you can read the whole dodgy crackers, what they've done to it. And I'll give you the game was like John Michel Jarre music, and it was all and really cool graphics, and it had this whole interface, you know, to translate between things, flying between worlds. Oh god. And look at this one. All of a sudden you can see you've got the choice between mono Hercules graphics or CGA. Right? Okay, Atari Starframe, you're gonna like really love this, because I only played the Atari game version of this. So when I came to this, this is what I experienced. Right. So let's say we're gonna use the mouse. Come on. So CGA graphics and the mouse and English. Oh, this is already a sign of what you're going to get. Yeah. I don't even know if you can hear me over the sound of this frigging noise. How about a couple minutes more? Okay, does that even sound... does that even sound anything like it? No. That is just... So I don't think Jean-Michel Jarre was endorsed this frigging version. It didn't do that. Yep, see, I think I'm pretty good at it. I'm better this frigging game at making the sound. Right. So, let's look at these amazing, beautiful graphics. It's just shitter. Look at this. Look at the state of it. And the little... I can't even move the friggin' crosshairs properly. There's something wrong with it, but that's fine. Let's try to launch. If I can... Oh, no. No. Francis Lyonnais? Lyonnais? No, what was he? No, Atari Starframe, we're going to just go to the... Let's just do a little bit of this. A little bit of this, because I think you deserve to see it. Because... Oh, was he the author of Stoss? Oh, I love Stoss. Way better than Amos. How do we take off? I think we used to go somewhere here. Is it this? One of these two. I'm going to go for the middle one. Yeah, there we go. So now we're at the new planet of purple, white and black, which is just bullshit, basically. And let's try to land on the planet. Look at the speed of this. Yeah. Okay. I don't even know why they used to persist in having this stupid rendered tunnel game. Yeah, it's shite. And then you had this, whatever that friggin' pod thing. Yeah, I used to love that finger. Look at the bend in it. Yeah, baby. Ah, yeah. Fucking yeah. Right. Getting a bit aggressive there, a bit sweary. Alright, it's shit. I think that's pretty much the conclusion. I'm just going to show you one more thing. If I can get out of this piece of rubbish. Let's just control out. Close down DOSBox. Was there any piece... Oh, for frig's sake, whoever designed this bloody interface? Right. Can anybody remember any PC game, though, which was produced in the sort of years... Here we go. 1980... to say 2000, that was any good? You probably can't even read this, but I'm just trying to think if any of these are any good. Syndicate Wars, MDK. I mean, MDK was friggin' good. Did anyone play MDK? Grand Theft Auto. It almost makes me feel dirty playing MDK in a sort of emulator thing, but it was... It was at... Oh yeah, the Incredible Machine. You saw... Did you see that video, Tim? That was bloody good game. Oh, hang on. Okay. MDK. Mark, if you've never heard of MDK, I think you've just amazingly missed out on so much stuff. Okay, I'm going to try playing this in math. This was a phenomenal game. I can't believe it. You've never played MDK. This was at a time when the graphics, before the 3DFX, VD2, any of that stuff came out, but the graphics were all software done, but were just phenomenal. Absolutely. Look at, just check this out. This is software rendering at, in whenever that was. Hey Paul, how are you? Okay, my mouse isn't working, so we'll have to do it keyboard. So you play this character, who I'm pretty sure is a lady, and it's sort of like had these sort of various mini games between levels. But it's a there we go. Now we can start. But yeah, it's a sort of French game. How do you? What is the parachute? Okay, remember I've got. Oh, the mouse is. Okay, so that's one bit. How do we move forward on the mouse? Well, mouse is basically, yeah, okay, it's kind of PC style controls. Let's do this. Although I don't know how you zoom on the mouse, it seems to need space to go into sniper mode. Yeah, bitch! There's a lot of humour in this game. The graphics were really, any idea how I use the world's smallest nuclear explosion? No. Okay. Maybe I'm not done in here. I love those bullets. Do you see them? They're like sort of homing. Oh, okay. Thank you. Anybody know how to deploy a nuke? Let's try tab, shall we? No. Control, Alt, Space, Carriage Return. Yes, Carriage Return. That did the trick. The mouse is really weird because if you accidentally push forward or back, which you think is going up or down, it tries to move your character because, of course, you don't do up and down. Do you remember Doom? You didn't matter anywhere on the Y plane where you're looking. If you shot, it would just kill whatever was there. Endless, endless tunnel of nothingness. Oh, bugger. Okay, there's three dudes up there, if I recall. How you control the zoom, I cannot remember. But I'm going to have to learn, otherwise we're not going to get anywhere in this. Page up, page down, no. Number keys, no, plus minus. Oh well, I don't know how to do the zoom on the sniper rifle, but we'll just. I'm just randomly pushing keys on. Ah! There we go. Best sniper rifle ever. There we go. Nice. Hand grenade. Oh, sugar. No, no, go back to DOSBox. These bloody old games with their old keys. Yeah, it says that, but it doesn't tell you what button was it to just do the hand grenade. Oh yeah, carriage return, the most obvious button. Right, clearly have to get that thing. But we don't know how. Use parachute to get mortar. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, that doesn't... Okay guys, let's try this. Come on, come on, come on! Yes! Right, how do we use this frigging thing? Ah, there we go. That'll do, pig. Carmageddon. So, Meph, are you asking me to switch to Carmageddon? Have you had enough of the murder, death, kill? Ah, sniper grenade. Come on, you want to see what a sniper grenade is, though. Oh, yeah. I see that's a generator, but I don't know. What's that thing? This mouse control is mental. Well, I certainly have Carmageddon, but there you go. I don't know if anybody who hasn't seen MDK, I definitely would suggest you give it a go because it's absolutely brilliant. And there's a sequel to it too. And the sequel, you could get a you could get an update for it. Carmageddon. Let's see if it's on this list of amazing. Oh, there it is. It was right bloody there. It was right bloody there. I'm expecting people to kick my door in going, you shouldn't be playing this. But I don't know, guys. I don't know. What's the status of Abandonware? High resolution mode, 640 by 480. When your video card does not list, the game will look exactly the same as before. 320 by 200. DOS 4GW, do you remember that? HiMem.sys, all of that jazz. Fantastic. Llamatron. Llamatron Atari stuff. What platform was Llamatron sort of on? I'm just going to go and adjust the volume levels because it's currently blowing my ear holes out. I think Llamatron would have to be on the Atari. Music. Okay, let's try it at a 2. There we go. Res Roma Diana. Let's go as the Blurk. I love this. Yeah, let's go somewhere in the middle. Problem with these games was that they just don't seem to have the, you know, ASWD keyboard control often. On the PC too, Llamatron on the PC, it's probably in bloody CGA, isn't it? I'll have to look it up. I wonder if it sort of is the classic sort of Jeff Minter type game. Or if it just sort of lost something, loses something in translation to the PC.
5, 4, 3, 2,
okay.
1, go!
Off to a bad start. Yep. Oh my god, it is sort of... Right. Something weird going on here. Right. Sorted.
Wrong checkpoint.
Crap. I don't remember it being this clunky. Because I've sort of recently got the Android version of this game. There you go, nicely done. Feels so sluggish now. I don't think I'm gonna win this race. Yes! I remember thinking this game was like the Mutt's Nuts. Like, you couldn't get better graphically than this. This was the shit. But now it just looks pixelated and terrible. Still, the car handling is just so much fun. Oh, you got me my kill, you bastard. Ah! Welcome to the Super Bowl. Woohoo! You're mine, boy. Alright. I think I want to get back to the race already. It just feels like you'll be here all day. Oh, there was used to be a map. There we go, map. Oh, it plays really fast now. If you're prepared to play it in a window view in the corner, it actually handles totally differently. Which is weird, considering it's running on a modern PC, it's actually being slowed down on purpose. I don't even remember Redneck Rampage. Was that something to do? Were you in like sort of hillbilly monster trucks? Hey, Mark. I just only realised it was you, Mr. Wallace. How the hell are you? I decided today that rather than make any sort of real video, I was just going to play around on games. So, the lovely Mr. Wallace. Virtually unplayable. Ah. Car's broken. Are you still a bit poorly or getting on with it? Ah, let's go. Let's go, Mr. Driver. I think I might stick to Super Nintendo games. Oh, not another bloody lap. Killing a bunch of hillbillies. That sounds like the right kind of redneck rampage. So are you trying to kill the hillbillies in sort of retaliation for them doing something to you? Like some sort of hillbilly butt-fucking? That's what they're famous for. Yeah, come on. Checkpoint. So, Meth, what we need to discover is, can DOSBox emulate a 3DFX card? Because if it can, then it seems to me like they're missing a trick by not configuring this up. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, no, 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 no! Shit! Bollocks. Mad Famous. So, what was this game? Hillbilly Redneck Rampage. Okay, Redneck Rampage. Let's just get out this frigging game. Get out, get out. I remember a taxi game that used the same engine as this. Whatever the hell that was called. Redneck Rampage. Let's go, Mr. Driver. Redneck Rampage. But you do have Return to Zork, that crazy game. Might and Magic, God. Midwinter, I never even played Midwinter. What was Midwinter like? Was that shite? Llamatron, we did say Llamatron though, that might be interesting. This is like where you shouldn't go back and play these games because you'll go, damn it, they were way crapper than you remember them. You can almost, they're almost unbearable to play. Llamatron, it's two L's actually, isn't it? No, I don't see it. No Llamatron. Midwinter for the ST. Are you sure you don't want to see Midwinter on the PC just to sort of see how rubbish it is, or will it just ruin me and I won't want to play it on anything else? I love how some of these games just sound so amazing and then when you load them they're just absolute tosh. Oh, this was so good on the Atari ST, North and South. Do you remember that? I'm going to load it up, but if it's not in VGA, I don't think it's worth even... You know, it's a non-starter because it's just going to be so poo. Select video card. It does do EGA. Come on, Tim. Commander Keen or North and South while I'm in it. You know, I'm in it now. Just a quick look, quick look, quick. Ah, my ears. Oh my God. Fucking hell. Yeah, let's just not. That is not like the Atari ST. Or Amiga versions. It just goes to show you really that there's that sort of period of a couple of years though between the two where they were just so much, they were just, let's just say it, they were raping the PC, just totally. And now, you know, the PC's just sort of, oh, Commander Keen. I remember playing these on cover discs. Do you remember that? What was the name of that company that used to do, oh, Apogee, it's just right there. Apogee just used to publish so many things. yeah, your earring tone, yeah. I just remember those sort of PC cover discs, and I can't remember the sort of name of the PC magazines at the time, but they just would always have these, and it was great, really. And I kind of think Duke Nukem was a cover disc game like this. Where's the sound? Ah, okay, there it is. So that's Walk. That's do, I don't know. Okay, can't do that. You have a ray gun apparently. Please press A key. Okay, A key didn't do anything. Okay, I just pushed. Control is jump. Don't see a shoot just yet, so I'm just gonna keep going. He is repping me. These sound effects right injected right into your ear hole are just bit intense. But do you remember headphones on PC gaming didn't exist? Do you remember we never ever used headphones on PCs? I never used it on Atari, I never used it on nothing. Although it's not that surprising because you don't really use headphones on your console at home, do you? Maybe you might. Right. Got the gun. Do you have to select it? It says 5 charges. Maybe I don't want to. Friggin' hell. Right. That's not a shoot. That's not a shoot. That's that. Shoot. Ah! Suck it, bitch. Right, out. Right, well, right out, I think it's shoot. So what are these things you're actually collecting? Yeah, thanks, Meph. I don't know how long I'm going to play on anyway, and I really appreciate you guys actually hanging out. I'm pretty sure this is definitely one of the least exciting sort of video game streams, but... oh, frig off. Oh, these bloody things. Right. But yeah, it's really just me playing at trying out the whole streaming thing. But yeah. Oh, shit. Who suggested this bloody game anyway? Tim. Tim, did you actually ever play this? Or are you just making me play it? Because I know I certainly played it a little bit as a youth, but I'm not sure I enjoyed it. Because this sort of was same time you had like Turrican and stuff on the Commodore 64, so this would have been pretty weak. Okay, there we go. Sorted. Why does he have to do a full-on jump every time? Even Super Mario didn't have to do that. No! There you go. You misremembered this game. But okay, let's just... Okay, you say you misremembered this one, but maybe it was a later version of this sort of title. I mean, look, there's Commander Keen 7, so let's just try that. Let's just go straight to Commander Keen 7. Keen Dreams.
Okay.
Shut up. Play the game. By the way, what's the Google voice lady called? Do you know what I mean? You've got Siri on the Apple, but does the one on the phone have on the Android phones have a name? Keen Dreams. Ooh. Okay, it's using the mouse. That's something. The Land of Tuberia. No, it's just the same old bollocks. Clearly. Oh wow, did you hear that music? Yeah, baby. Actually, this is handling much better. They got their shit together for this. Is this the one you remember, Tim? Mark, you know, I know you just wrote Xenon there, and I did a recent sort of, I think it was top 5 Atari ST games, and on that sort of video was Xenon. Yeah, this is 2.5D, Tim. Old school style. There was Xenon 2, and we know that the Atari ST version is going to be better than the PC one, and that it kind of sucked. It really was disappointing because I remember at the time, oh, it's so cool. But probably the only cool thing about Xenon was the fact that they managed to get quite a long sampled or modded, however it was done, audio track into it, which to me now sounds a lot like the frigging Clothes Show. Do you remember the Clothes Show? That was on around the same time as Before Food and Drink on a Tuesday or something. What, Xenon's the one you play to death? Well, I think we get the idea of Commander Keen anyway. I kind of quite like Commander Keen, but alright, this does play quite good. Tim, if this was the version you remember, then I totally thumbs up, because that's not bad. That's kind of, I'm not going to say Mario level gameplay, but certainly not shit. I guess that's the right way to phrase that. Xenon. Oh, there's not even Xenon on here. Bugger. Oh no. There's not even Xenon on here apart from Xenon and Xenon 2. Okay, Mark. Come on, tell us. Which one? Xenon 1 or Xenon 2? Which one do you want, sir? I'm going to kind of hover over Xenon 2 because if any is going to be better, that's going to be the better one because I don't even remember trying Xenon. So I'm going to give you 10 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, there we go. I had to sort of slow that down because of the sort of lag. Yeah, not shit. By Windows 10, it's not so shit. I did customize the keys. It's going to be a total fudge fest here. Oh, yes. Good job, guys. That's better sound than the Amiga version. Oh, I'm going to hear it in stereo. Okay. Oh, cool. Oh, shit. Is the music off or music on? I assumed the music would be on and I went to music off. But is this to turn it off or is this to turn it on? Fudge. All right. Please be off. Okay, I'm ready. Spoink, 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 little spunks. Ooh. I'm not hating it. I'm not hating it because the sound is the music's off, I think. I kind of remember this pad being quite mediocre though in terms of it's all bosses and whatnot. Come on, I'm spoinking everywhere. Oh, that's, you know, it's really annoying me, and it's going to annoy you when I point it out. Look at the rear cannon. In fact, the rear cannon is worse than the front, but both of them are offset. So the cannons clearly would be in the center of your craft, but look where they're coming out. The rear cannon is definitely way to the left, and the front cannon is like one pixel to the left. Look. Shit. If I was designing this game, I would just have added an extra sort of pixel so you could just get the bullets to come out of the middle. Or I'd make the bullets a bit wider. Mark, this is mental, by the way. I'm not sure if these enemies are taking multiple hits or if the collision detection's really bad. Also, it feels like your ship is massive. You say it's like a vertical scrolling R-Type, Tim, but no. No, it's not. R-Type, you had that hold down charge up cannon, which that just brilliant. Here, you're just shit. It's okay, you know, watch. You just can't shoot fast enough to get the, oh, what? No. Oh yeah, no, this is cool. I think it lets you go backwards. There you go. Cock. Oh my god. Yeah, but R-Type. Oh, that R-Type came out way before this too. Which version of the... I think R-Type on the PC Engine was pretty good too. I'm going to have to really dig out R-Type. If you've got an Xbox 360, or probably Xbox One, there was an R-Type that you could download from the Xbox Store, whatever it was called. And it was really cool because it had the old graphics, so you could play it. And then even mid-playing, you could flip one of the shoulder buttons and it would turn it into like some new funky modern graphics. But you could just switch between them all the time. So that was really fun because you could just... Fudge. You could just like, you know, just flip it. So you go, I wonder what that looks like in 8-bit mode. Ooh, that's neat. I wonder what it looks like, you know, in modern graphics. So try it. I insist you try it. And then send me a Steam key and give it to me for free. Balls. This is balls. Balls, 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 balls. Oh, yeah. What do you want to sell me? That. I will pay 500. Okay, I will take 500. I don't want to sell anything, so Oh, what? I can't buy? Ah, phew. What's the price of these things? They all look crap. I want this horse's head thing, or is it in Australia? Oh, the supernatural power. Give me the cash. Fine. Let's get the hell out of Oh, what the frig was that? Oh, you only get 7 seconds of it, and you're in a bit where there's no friggin' enemies. I wish you just had that all the time. Oh, there's a cheat, I think. You got to type in, hi, I'm Johnny Ive or something. You got to type in a thing and it'll just let you have that super Nashwan power all the time. Or it might be a really rude thing you got to type in. Like the original name of that character in Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy who Douglas Adams wanted to call Farty Fuckballs, but I can't remember what he called him in the end. Who was Farty Fuckballs? And that's not spelt at all how it's pronounced. Alright, I just realised something, because that whole gameplay thing of going backwards, yeah, I'm dying a lot because obviously you're supposed to stop the screen so you can clear it before you just charge ahead. Yeah. Oh, it doesn't seem to be letting me. It only lets you do it for a bit. Slarty Bart Fast! That's it! Slarty Bart Fast. See, Slarty Bart Fast, I can't read anything weird into that. That's just a weird alien name, but Farty Fuckballs was a bit on the nose. But I love it. I have never tried Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency, and I kind of feel I'm sort of doing doing it a misjustice to the author. So I really need to have a go at that, because obviously he was one of my favourite authors, him and Ian M. Banks. Oh my god. And I do like Terry Pratchett, and I've read all of his books, but I have to admit, I don't know, towards the end, and I don't think he's dead. I know that's pretty mean of me to say, but I wasn't feeling it in the same way as those sort of original Colour of Magic and those ones. I don't even remember this having music. There's just no music then. Oh, that was digitized sound. Yeah, it's set. Precursor to Doom. This totally passed me by the way. I never ever saw Wolfenstein till way after playing Doom, because I was on the sort of PC and I thought the graphics in Lure of the Temptress on the Atari ST was amazing, even though I had a PC at the time, but I was really playing sort of Rainbird's Carrier Command and games like that on the PC. It looks like my modern day PC just does not have the gumption to be able to run Wolfenstein. Does anybody have a spare 3D card, like a Diamond S3 Verge or a Matrox Mystique? Oh, TIE Fighter. TIE Fighter was good, but X-Wing was better. Classic. Absolutely classic. If you like a flying shoot 'em up space simulator type game which has loads of shield management. Mark Wallace. Mr. Wallace, sir. Now tell me, I suspect you are an elite dangerous
sir,
fan.
Our TIE interceptors have located a rebel fleet orbiting the planet Orkana.
Excellent.
Prepare the attack.
Move our star destroyers within range. And
that's some good voice acting there. Shit, that's good. Let's do it. Skip. Oh, there was loads of keys on this.
This is Red Leader. Stay close and watch for enemy fighters.
Tell you what, Lucasfilm games were just so friggin' good.
I can't take him.
I'm on him.
Nice shot, Red 2.
God, come on, come on. Hang on, did I? I just thought I loaded up TIE Fighter.
You must register.
Okay, log in.
You may proceed.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Blah, 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 blah.
Shadow
Party. Welcome to tour of duty registration, sir.
So yeah, Mark, yeah, I haven't played Elite Dangerous for yonks because it's such a time suck. And but this is really, really similar Elite Dangerous gameplay. Sort of. You'll see. Color, okay. I'm really confused now. I don't know what game I'm playing. I don't know what I am. Oh, just get out. Oh, I don't want to play Goody. The TIE Fighter version was really good because it came out before the X-Wing, but okay. I'll give it a go. Okay. That's your weapon systems, clearly. Yeah, don't do that. So, Mark, you saw that, right? You got the repair screens. Cannons, setting your cannon chaining. Replay camera. What I've done, though... Oh, there we go. That's the shield management. Right, forward shield. How will we set our speed? Speed set to full. Where is our radar? Targeting. There we go.
Target destroyed.
Where is it? Where is it? Oh, stop that. I'm going to start having to write down the keys for these things. Come on, how do we chain the guns? There we go. Going to fire my Fruton torpedoes. So it's like 3.3, I don't know what that is, AUs. Yeah, this was great. I remember playing this. This is probably probably a little bit before, probably around university time, but TIE Fighter was definitely university time, and it was really good. Because if you remember, like, Wing Commander and stuff came out, but that it was a weird 2D... Oh, That's on D, by the way, that button. Yeah, that's why you hit it continuously. Come on, R2. Get your shit together. Yeah, that wasn't so good. Forgot my basic pilot training of slaying down on the pass. But it's a bit choppy. That choppiness isn't just the video, that is actually what it's like. Front view. Oh, it's actually, look, it's even moving, that thing. I'm not sure where all my bloody buddies were that were shooting the crap out of the other one with me. Oh. Alright, guys, I guess I ought to go and do some dad things. I really thank you for spending the time with me this evening. I hope it wasn't too painful for you. And maybe next time it'll be a bit slicker and we'll work out in advance a game that is actually quite interesting. Quite interesting to play. In the meantime, I was going to try to ram that if it wasn't keep disappearing off my screen. Look at that. It's really eating the horsepower in my PC. So as ever, thank you for watching. Do you want to view the flight recorder? Yeah, I'll view the flight recorder while I'm trying to figure out how to stop streaming. But yeah, thanks everybody. Thank you so much for your support on Twitter and YouTube, and I really appreciate it all. Mwah! Kisses to you all.